Welcome to After Total Divas. I'm Renee Young alongside Miss Alicia Fox. You doing good today?
Oh, I'm good. How you doing?
I'm good.
Good.
So me and Fox, we're going to be recapping everything that happens on Total Divas, which only makes sense because the show is called After Total Divas. So that's what we will be doing today, delving deep into topics, sorting through all sorts of issues that happen amongst our coworkers here, of course, the Total Divas. So our very first topic here on our Total Diva dish is road rage.
Oh my God, I feel like I've set myself for a huge freaking disaster.
It's about you not accepting responsibility.
Oh, is this how you treat TJ? Is this why you and TJ have problems?
That's a low blow.
Well, it's true.
Daddy, where are you going?
Lord, please get these girls back in the car. I just want to get on the road.
Why are you crying?
I just can't handle this right now. It's like too stressful.
Have you ever seen Natalia go that postal before in your life on anybody, let alone just Summer Rae?
Okay, I think everyone in this episode had a sip of cray. Everyone was showing their sassy.
They've
side,
all gone bonkers.
Bonkers. Oh, nice. But no, I have never seen Natalia go cray like that before. It was cool because Natty's always like strawberry shortcake. And then all of a sudden she goes cray. I'm like, all right, now this girl's more like, you know, Izzy Azalea. And I dig that. I dig it.
I like that Rosa took it upon herself to just start crying because she didn't know what else to do.
Yeah,
what? I would have just sat back and been like, watch all these girls go crazy. All right, our next topic is no money, mo problems.
So I hear you guys are, you know, definitely starting to think about stepping your lives.
Yes.
Let's start thinking about transitioning from, you know, the entertainment world to more of a corporate professional setting. You know, you really want to think about what you're bringing to the table.
I've taken something that I invented myself, which was a yes chant, and now it translates not only into the wrestling industry, but also into multiple sports worlds.
Are you going to be able to support a family on the yes chant?
It's really discouraging because Brian and I couldn't just go out there and apply for a job. We really now have to dig deep and figure out what is it that we can do on our own.
Bree and Brian, of course, trying to plan out their future, trying to decide what they're gonna do after WWE comes to an end, which is inevitable. I mean, things happen, you move on.
Did you ask John for a loan?
Well, like, I can't believe he called you. Like, what a stooge.
Don't blame this on John. You shouldn't have even asked him. You should have talked to me about it. It makes me look bad. Like what? Like I can't take care of my own family?
Do you think that the way John handled the situation with Brie having asked Nikki for money was the right way to go about business for them?
I think it was the most logical, for sure.
Yeah. He was being a businessman, he wanted to nip it in the bud, but him dealing with Daniel Bryan one-on-one, I think was a manly thing to do. Just unfortunately, Bryan didn't know what was going on, but Brie's heart was in the right place, agree?
Right, but how funny, I mean, she called him out and called him a stooge. When she said that, I was like, Brie. I know, I was like, ooh, girl, spicy.
All right, our last topic is have a little faith in me.
I want to have the Catholic wedding because I didn't want to disappoint you.
Right.
But Jonathan's not going to convert.
You know, I want you to do the Catholic thing. The Catholic thing is what we're all about. We've always been that way. But by the same token, you guys are the ones that got to make a life. Yeah. You got to have his back. He's got to have your back. That's just the way it is. And I'll support you.
To have my dad's approval and have him say that he's going to support me, hearing those words out of his mouth is all that I really needed. And to have that is the best feeling in the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the guest of today's episode, the lovely Eva Marie.
Yes. Hello, ladies.
What's
thank
up,
you
girl?
For having me.
How are you doing?
I'm really good, thank you.
How are you and Jonathan doing?
You know what? Him and I are doing fabulous.
Yeah?
Yes.
Where is he right now? What's he doing?
Yeah. He is back home handling business, working, and, you know, doing his thing.
Getting all beast.
Getting all beast.
Girl, we want to dig into all your business, starting with the simple question of, okay, so how do you make the transition from putting Jonathan first versus like pleasing your parents, you know, the people that put you on this earth?
Right.
You know, I think that would be tough.
It's definitely hard for me because I am the baby girl. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I feel like I have all this pressure just because it's like, I'm a daddy's girl. I have three older brothers, so it's like I try juggling that. You see that on, you know, on Total Divas. Yeah. So, you know, it's time to really realize, like, this is my husband. I wake up to you every single day. My family will always be there for me through thick and thin. So I'm so thankful that my dad, you know, he can see the love between Jonathan and I, and he's never seen that before for me. So he just was there to be like, you know what, I support you. I love you. Mm-hmm. If this makes you happy.
Now, here's the thing. I love all of the Total Divas very much. I think you're all very lovely girls, very talented. But your dad's my favorite person on the show.
Very
nice. I love your dad. Yes. Every time he comes in, he's like, I love him. He cracks me up every time.
We need him on the show.
Seriously, he's amazing. Talk about, like, Italian man to the fullest.
It's great.
Very, you know, he's loving, but he's just... He's so him.
He cracks me up. Yeah. And just like when you walk in the room, you can see he's just like, yeah, he loves it. You guys talking on the phone, anything. Yeah. I love him.
He's
so
the best.
If we can, I'm formally making a request to Mr. Barry Nelson.
Yes.
To please.
Oh my God.
Please come on after Total Divas as a guest.
I would love that.
I will buy you lunch. I'll buy you dinner. I'll get you whatever you need. I'll have a Catholic wedding. I'll do whatever you need for you to come on the show.
Next week on Total Divas.
Sure.
I just feel exhausted and in a lot of pain.
What if they say we can't have kids?
You need to back off.
Natty is looking super hot.
You can just sit here and be angry when there's nothing we can do.
She's just snappy.
No one said you had to hang out with me. You're my sister. You're not my friend.
All right, guys, me and Alicia Fox will be back here next week to recap everything that happens on Total Divas. Of course, you can catch that on the E! Network at 9 p.m. Eastern Time on Sundays, and we'll be right back here chatting about everyone and making our love known to Mr. Barry Nelson.
Yes.
Thank you for coming on the show today.
Thanks for having me, girl.
We'll see you guys next week.
Yes.
Bye.